sea dolphins. I think I'm gonna cry. I'll definitely cry. Hi, it's Margarita, and on this channel we talk about sustainability, nature connection, and animal conservation. Today's video is going to be an interesting one, but so are all other videos on my channel. That is why I am inviting you to subscribe to it so you can stay up to date with all the important environmental success stories that are happening out there. In today's video, we're going to be talking about whale watching tourism and some of the very important things that I have learned from a team of marine researchers that we have visited few months ago, and we managed to raise awareness about very important work that they're doing to help marine animals and to protect our oceans. So definitely check it out. If you watch this video till the end, you will become better at choosing animal tourism activities, and you would be able to help those majestic creatures like whales and dolphins. And don't forget to share this video with a friend. You might help them out as well. Whale and dolphin watching is on everyone's bucket list. It is an extraordinary experience that lets you see those majestic creatures in the wild, appreciate their beauty, and feel connected to them. And that is exactly the reason why there are so many tour operators out there who offer this experience to the general public and tourists. They would promise you a life-changing experience and even promise you to return the money if you don't see the whales. High demand, of course, led to the increasing amount of boats in the areas where dolphins and whales live. Those loud boats with motors and propellers are following animals all day long, and there are a lot of things that can harm them. At least 13 million people go whale watching every year, and this industry is estimated to be worth £1.32 billion, according to the International Fund for Animal Welfare. In short, it is a very big business. Whale watching becomes a problem when it becomes extreme. When it's not just you, the whale, and the deep blue ocean, but it's you, the whale, the deep blue ocean, and 300 other people cramped around a single animal.
Biggest concerns are with sound, because they are very acoustic creatures. So the presence of vessels will cause a lot of noise pollution, which is detrimental to their hearing and communication. Let's say you're in a club with a friend and the music is really loud, and you are changing the way you're talking. You're talking louder, you're saying shorter sentences, but the noise is still there.
I am a huge believer that by connecting people to nature and providing them with ethical experiences as well as environmental education, we can foster environmental stewards who would then, after this experience, help us to protect environment and species in the wild. So if you choose to do it, please do it right. Watch this video till the end and also share it with your friends so they know as well.
Look for whale-watching tour operators that preach conservation and have links to charities. You want to be out there on a tour with a whale enthusiast that loves these animals more than you. Somebody who's more interested in their welfare than just a decent picture.
Have you ever gone whale watching yourself? What was your experience like? Would you be able to recommend this organization to other travelers from the ethical point of view? If so, drop the name of the organization and the country in the comments. Let's all help each other out.
Most countries have clear guidelines on whale watching, which includes stopping distances, not moving in front of the whales to block their path, and turning off motors if there are whales in the area.
There are different regulations based on the country and also on the organization. 100 meters of the dolphin, so you can be near them, up to 30 meters, with the staying time of around 30 minutes, and 3 boats allowed within those 100 meters of the dolphins. Any additional boats have to wait outside of the 300 meter radius.
So if your guides are not following the rules, call them out on it.
Google, search online, try to talk with friends that were there before and maybe they can recommend you. If you go dolphin watching or whale watching and you have a bad experience, well, tell first your skipper, your guides, make them a review on TripAdvisor or, well, the, any website that you think is appropriate. It's a better experience for everyone on board. for your clients, we'll observe better the animals with more natural behaviors.
You've got to be prepared to not get close, to view from a safe distance and allow the animal to approach you if it wants to, and swim away if it doesn't. Your tour operator should not chase them and instead look for other whales. A company should never guarantee seeing a whale, because a legit company would never jeopardize breaking rules to satisfy a customer. Sailboats and kayaks aren't as fast as motorboats, and they might not offer the same chance of seeing the animals given their limitations, but since they're much more quieter than motors, they're much more less likely to disturb the whales. So when possible, choose noise-limiting options for whale watching. The right tour operator would inspire their customers to care about both the whales and the whales' environment, and teach them how to translate that care into action. In practice, this means providing accurate information about the whales' biology and behavior, what they need to survive, what their world is like, and describing the threats that whales face, for example, declining prey, pollution, and underwater noise. Whale watching companies that employ well-educated, experienced, knowledgeable captains and naturalists who can do that and deliver these messages get high ranks in our books. Consider joining AIM to be part of their research team. They offer internships and qualifications for students, as well as for other passionate ocean lovers. Animals are my biggest passion in life, and I think that my true purpose is to be creating entertaining and educational content about animals and environment. And what really got me into it was my first ever experience of seeing dolphins in the wild. That is why this project is so special for me, because I'm so excited to experience that feeling again, seeing dolphins in the wild, because I still remember how my heart felt at that moment 8 years ago. I was still a teenager, I was about 19. I used to work on a cruise ship where we're cruising through Alaska, which is stunning by itself. I remember that day when I came out on the boat, on a cruise ship, massive cruise ship, and we're gliding through glaciers and mountains and beautiful scenery. And then I remember this beautiful pod of dolphins and a few whales, humpback whales, were just following our cruise. And it was just so beautiful. It was just so stunning. It was mesmerizing. And at that point in my life, I thought that this is life. This is life. What life is all about. Seeing things like that and trying to do something good for those animals that actually makes a difference. So I was joining a marine research boat there in Alaska, and I was just like getting interested in what they were doing and how I can get involved. And this is something that got me inspired to study zoology. That is it for today. Thank you so much for watching, guys. You are now part of the marine research team, so you can help us to spread those messages around and to raise more awareness about important work that those environmental organizations are doing. And I would like to thank you for being here. Don't forget to give this video a like, and I will see you here next week.
Where am I going?
At 1 o'clock with us.
Yes, like that.
No, no, come on, get away. Get close.